grab your bolster and sit up on your bolster. It's nice to have props up underneath your butt because at first the hips and the knee joints are tight. So as you sit onto the bolster, bring your hands back behind you, lift your butt up, and then slide your knee forward. But take your fingertips back behind you and just lift your chest up. As you lift your chest up, let your shoulder blades come towards one another. Core strong, rest your hands on your thighs, relax your elbows, draw your gaze down towards the tip of your nose, and close your eyes. I'm trying to leave your eyes open, just gazing softly down towards the earth. Reflecting upon your daily morning ritual, perhaps you are out in the water catching some waves, maybe you had breakfast and coffee. Just reflect on all the things you did since you got out of your bed this morning. Those are choices you made, judgments you had. Maybe this morning was exactly like every other morning. Or there was a different call, a different choice that you made. Just reflect on the choices you had this morning. Even arriving onto your yoga mat right now, there was a desire. You came to yoga for something. What was it that you're seeking? That it's already right here now, without the practice, whatever it was you were looking for is already here. Start to tune into the breeze from the fans. The sound of the jungle. The construction workers, their voices. With all of that, lift your chest up, open your heart as you move shoulder blades on your back. Draw the gaze closer inside as you become aware of your inhale and your exhale. Notice what you're feeling this morning. Bhagavad gita teaching from India relating to a story that pertains to our life now, human conditions, lessons, and desires. Knowing that the choices that you made this morning affect where you are right now. Or even not doing something is action in and of itself. A quote from Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. Not doing is even an action in and of itself. So as humans, we'll always have desire, judgment, and constantly making choices, even if that choice is to not do anything at all. Choose to stay in the very first variation, or if you choose to deepen, understand why it is that you're going farther, so that the judgments you are making on your mat can be cultivated and practiced to make the best judgment for where you are right now. Sit tall, watch your breath. As you become aware of the internal world going on inside of you, stay present and aware of all the external things going on outside of you. Mm-hmm. go somewhere other than inside or feeling the external world, the noises, the breathing. Come back. Choosing to come back. Open as you move forward onto your hands and knees, taking a little props out of your way. If knees are sensitive, you can always place that blanket underneath of your knees for additional support. Two blocks at the top of your mat on the outer edges, shoulders over the wrists, hips over the knees. Inhale, lift your butt, lift your heart, open your chest, look up. Exhale, tuck your chin around your spine, curl in, cat pose. Inhale, open, cow pose. Let your breath guide you. Inhale, open your heart, lift your chest. Exhale, your chin, round your spine. As you round your spine, imagine lifting your heart all the way up. Inhale, mount your chest, look up, lift your chin. Breath guides you. Exhale, curl around, hug it. Inhale, lift, open your chest. Neutralize the spine as you gaze to the earth. Curl your toes under. Inhale, shift your shoulders just past your fingertips. Exhale, bend the elbows straight back towards your hip creases, lower towards your chest and your chin. Keep elbows hugging the outer edge of your ribcage as you slither through onto your belly. Fingertips are still in line with the shoulders. Lift your right leg, stretch it back. Lower your right foot to the floor. Lift your left leg, stretch your back, lower your left foot to the floor. Hug elbows in. Tuck your chin, gaze to the earth. Inhale, slide the hands back towards your hips, lift your chest. As you move the shoulder blades back towards one another, let your neck get long, reaching through the top of your head. Exhale, lower down. Tap your forehead onto the earth. Hug your elbows by your ribcage. Keep your elbows hugging the ribcage. As you inhale, slide the hands towards the toes. As you move the shoulder blades back towards one another, get long, reach through the top of your head. Nice adjustment. Exhale, lower back down. One more on your own. Inhale, lift your chest. hug elbows in, strong legs, relax your butt muscles, exhale, lower. Press into your hands, curl your toes under, shift your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Inhale, look to the top of your mat and walk forward. Grab your blocks, place them underneath of your shoulders. Feet are as wide as your hips. Inhale, reach your chest forward, gaze to the floor as you press through your inner thighs, rotating them inward and back. Reach through your heart. Really draw your shoulders down your back and towards one another so side body is long. Tuck your chin just a little bit. A little more, right? Yeah. Keep working your thighs back. Even if hamstrings are tight right now, breathe into them as you send heels into the floor. Reach your butt up. Just extending through the top of your head as you press your thighs back. As thighs shift back, send your heels into the earth. Feel the hamstrings. Send your breath into the hamstrings. Pull back body, long. Heart opening forward, thighs moving back. Lift all 10 toes and individually set your toes down one by one. Finding the four corners of your feet to anchor you into the earth. As you continue to reach your heart forward, send your thighs back, lift your booty up to the sky. Tilt the butt up. Lift your sitting bones higher as you send your heels into the earth. Heart forward, thighs back, heels grounded, breathe. Press into all four corners of your feet. Draw your kneecaps up towards your hips. Bring one hand to the hip at a time. Strong legs, flat back. Rise all the way up to standing, tadasana. Lowering your arms down by your sides. Palms face forward. Close your eyes. Draw your belly button in towards your spine as you send your pubic bone down. This will lift your butt up as you send your heels into the earth. Shoulders move towards one another on the back as your heart lifts to the sky. Sending energy down through your fingertips as you reach up through the top of your head. Find a really strong stance. Stable, grounded, and rooted like a mountain. Breathe into the strength that you cultivate here. Inhale, reach your arms forward, palms face to the floor. Turn the palms to face one another and now move the shoulders onto your back. Keep the navigation of your shoulder blades towards one another as you inhale, reach your arms up. Shoulders move from the ears. Breathe into the outer edges of your ribcage, side body long. Draw shoulder blades down and towards one another. Breathe into the outer edge of your ribcage, strong legs. Inhale, exhale, arms to the side, fold forward, hinge from your hips. Place your hands onto your blocks, inhale, flat back. Set your blocks to the side, plant your hands, the distance of your shoulders, step back, downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, feet, hips distance apart. Spread through your fingers, press down through each individual finger, the knuckle, and the heel of your hand. Bend your knees. Send your heels to the ground as you lift your sitting bones high. Draw in through your core. Bend your right knee, send your left heel to the floor. Keep equal weight in your shoulders, equal weight in your arms. Send the left heel to the floor. Just the left heel, right knee is bent. Straighten your right leg, bend your left knee, sending just your right heel to the earth. Equal weight stays in your arms, side body long, extending the top of your head towards your thumbs. Straighten your left leg. Inhale, ripple forward, plank pose, shoulders above your wrists. We're going to hold, plank, option to lower the knees. Extend your heels back behind you, reach your heart forward, gaze down. Draw your core in, breathe. Heart reaching forward, heels extending back, hugging in. Bend your knees, lift your hips up. Extend your heels to the earth, downward facing dog. Inhale, look towards your thumbs. Walk one foot forward and then the other. Place your hands up to your hips. Inhale, flat back with your shoulders parallel to the earth. Send your thighs back, engage your legs. Rise to standing. Arms lower by your sides and out and up. Shoulders move towards one another as palms face one another. Urdhva Hastasana, breathe into the outer edges of your ribcage. Ground through your feet. Right hand connects to left wrist. Reach up through your left fingertips. Stretch to your right. Shoulders from the ears, left hip to the left. Rotate your left arm down towards the earth. Breathe into the backside of your left rib cage. So Liz, come forward with your left arm more. Yeah. Slowly rotating the left arm back. And slightly behind you to lift up through the front side of your rib cage. Press through your right foot, inhale back to center. Switch side. Left hand grabs right wrist, reach up through your right hand and stretch to your left. Sending your right hip out to the right. Shoulders from the ears, long right side body. Rotating the right shoulder, right arm down towards the floor, creating more space in the back right rib cage. Rotating the right shoulder blade back and slightly behind your hips as you lift the front side of your right rib cage. Breathing space into the intercostal muscles. Pressing through your left foot, reach your arms up. Separate the palms out and down. Stand tall, mountain pose. Tadasana, hands by your side, close your eyes. Feel the energy in your body. Put your hands up to your hips. Press your thighs back. Move your hips back. Reach your arms up. Now as you do this, thighs move back, chest lifts up. So from your heart space, there's a string reaching up towards the sky. As you keep moving your thigh bones back, open through the front side of your body. Thighs back, chest forward, strong feet. Good. Exhale, release your arms down by your side. Reach out, inhale, look up. Exhale, arms out, heart forward, fold. Plant your hands underneath of your shoulders. Step your way back into downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg to the sky. Keep the hips level to the earth. Shoulders stay exactly where they are. Bend your right knee, right heel to the butt. Rotate your right knee up towards the sky. Right shoulder blade comes back down, stacking just the hips. Hug your right heel more into your butt. Lift your right knee higher. Send your breath through the top. top of your right hip, flex it. Straighten your right leg, square your hips to the floor. Slowly lower your right foot onto the earth. Strong hands, shoulders down the back. Inhale, left leg lifts. Bend the left knee. Stack your left hip over your right hip. Lift the left knee to the sky. Hug the left heel to the butt. As you lower the left shoulder blade down so that it's directly in line with your shoulder, your right shoulder. Intentionally breathe through your front left hip. Straighten the left leg. Square your hip. Lower your left foot onto the earth. Downward dog. Down dog can always be child's pose. It's your judgment call, your choice, what you need most in your body. Know that child's pose is always an option. Inhale, step your right foot forward in between your hands, low lunge. Lower your left knee onto the floor and grab your blocks. Lift your chest up. Straighten and lift your left leg. Reach your hips back, straighten your right leg. Fold forward. Exhale, bend both of your knees, left knee to the floor, right knee over the right ankle, lift your chest, sink through the front left hip. Inhale, straighten, lift your hips, fold forward, shoulders on the back. Exhale, bend your knees, strong core, lift your chest. Check in with the choice you make. Maybe blocks come down a notch, or you set them off to the sides completely. Straighten the right leg, fold. Long spine. Exhale, bend your knees, lift your chest, open your heart. Exhale, straighten. Letting the breath guide you and move you. Good, bend both your knees, set your blocks to the sides, plant your hands. Step back, downward facing dog. Take a moment, digest the first side. Notice what it feels like in your right side. Switch, left foot comes forward. Lower your right knee to the earth, grab the block. Inhale, straighten both of your legs, see hips high. Full front leg. Bend your knees, lift your chest, low lunge, open the heart up. Exhale, straighten. Breath to guide and move you. Hips square forward, left hip draws back, right hip reaches forward the whole time. Feel into your hips and your hamstrings. Shoulder blades always staying towards one another on the back. Both your knees, lower the right knee down, take your blocks, set them out of your way, plant your palms, strong arms, lift your right knee, step your left foot back, downward facing dog. Right foot steps forward in between the hands, left hand to the edge of your mat on a block or off, reach your right fingertips over towards the jungle to your right, bring the right shoulder blade onto your back. Reach your right arm up towards the sky, twist. You may find that you need to heel toe your right foot more forward so that the right knee is directly over front right ankle. And coming more to the center of your left foot as you send your left heel back. Lift through the pelvis to a strong core. Rotate the left side of your rib cage towards your right knee. Right hand comes down, step back, downward dog. Left foot forward in between the hands, low lunge. Right hand to the edge of your mat on a block of the earth. Reach your left fingertips over to the left, out to the street. Reach your left shoulder blade onto your back as you extend your left arm up towards the sky. Keeping the hips lifted. Left hip back, right hip forward, bend that front left knee over the ankle, extend back through your right heel. Strong legs, the foundation of your posture, root through your legs. Rotate from your right rib cage over towards your left knee as you extend your left arm up. Shoulders. Move the shoulder blades towards one another and keep the shoulder blades reaching towards one another as you fold over your front right leg. Spine is long. Reach through the top of your head as you slightly tuck your chin into your chest. Look down towards your right knee. Making choices. If you choose to set your blocks off to the side or turn them down a level, keeping the spine long and the heart open. Bend your front right knee, set your blocks to the side, step back downward facing dog. So take a moment, actually just bring your knees down onto the ground. I just want to show you in my body and then play with it in your own body. So I adjusted you, but I want you to see the difference. So option here is to, as you fold forward, you're rounding in and your shoulders are down. But if you come from this space, you're going to stretch through the back body on the back and the back of the leg. So shoulders move together on your back, chest reaches forward, and then you fold from here. So at first you might be here, but try to refrain from rounding a bit farther down, more from lengthening and lifting. Let's try the second side, downward facing dog. Left foot steps forward, right knee lowers to the ground. Grab your blocks, shift your hips towards your right heel, flex your left toes to the sky. Inhale, lift your heart up, draw your shoulders on your back. Keep this, your heart is completely open. So you keep the chest wide as you tuck your chin, forehead comes down. Nice. Hips square forward, awesome. Breathe and extend through your heart as you fold over the front left leg. Half splits. Breathing into the back left hamstring. Maybe feeling a little bit more into your right hip flexor. Choose, make the judgment call in your own body, whether you use blocks or you come down onto the earth. Good. Bend your left knee, set your blocks to the side, plant your palms, step back, down dog. Use this time to just feel into the backside of your hamstrings now. A little bit more space. Right foot steps forward in between the hands. Lower your left knee to the earth. Right hand to right thigh, left hand to right hand. Pressing down onto your right thigh, draw your shoulders back, lift your chest up. Sinking your hips forward as you lift your heart up. Draw your shoulders down from your ears. Reach your arms forward in front of you. Shoulders come around on your back. Even open your arms out to the side. Feel the shoulder blades moving towards one another. Lift your arms up. Nice. Long neck, shift the hips forward. Sink through your front left thigh as you open your heart. Move shoulder blades towards one another. Reach through the top of your head. Breathe. Gaze can start to look up towards the tips of your fingers as you shift hips forward. Pubic bone presses down, heart reaches up. Beautiful expression. Strong core, move your hips back. Stillness, feel the breath. Strong core, shift your hips back, plant your palms to the earth, step back, downward facing dog. Right foot comes forward in between your hands. Root down through your feet, reach your arms towards the mirror in front of you and rise up, crescent lunge. Keep navigating shoulders towards you on the back as you reach through the top of your head. Send left heel back, bend your right knee. Strong core as you reach up. Exhale, bend your elbows, cactus your arms. Looking forward on the ground, find a drishti, a focus point. Bring more weight into your right foot. Come up onto your left toes and fly. Warrior three pose, left leg becomes parallel to the floor. Arms can come out like wings on an airplane or extend forward in front of you. Flying warrior. Right hip lifts, left hip lowers. Flex your left toes back. Down towards the ground. Strong right foot. Step your left foot forward. Feet hips distance apart, arms stay up. And exhale, lower the hands down, palms reach forward. Take a moment, close your eyes. right hand to right hip. Bend your left knee. Left hand onto the left ankle. Bring knees together. Look down. Make sure that your right foot is parallel to the long edge of your mat, pointing forward. Notice your habits. Reach the right arm up. Draw the right shoulder down and away from the right ear. Inhale, chest comes forward. Exhale, kick your left foot into your left hand. Strong right leg. Bring left hip down. So left hip stays in line with the right hip. As left foot goes back, heart comes forward. Natarajasana, dancer pose. Breathe. Left knee stays pointing to the earth. Yes, nice adjustment. Reach with your heart. Extend through your back left foot. Reach through your front right fingertips. Left knee comes to meet the right. Arms lower. Mountain Tadasana. Feel. And flow. Inhale, arms reach out, look up. Exhale, thighs move back, heart reaches forward. Plant your palms. Inhale, flat back. Maybe you come up onto fingertips. Exhale, step back, downward facing dog. Your arms, strong legs, fluid breath, amazing focus. Exhale, bend the elbows, cactus your arms. Start to get light on your back right foot. Find your drishti, your focus point in front of you. Begin to fly. Right leg comes off the earth. Right foot flexes. Right toes towards the mirror. Strong left leg, fluid breath, gaze is soft. Tuck the chin just a little bit. Any variation with your arms. Nice. Can you drop that right hand just a little bit, Mike? A little more. Lift your left. Yeah. Good. Bend your left knee. Step your right foot forward, Tadasana, at the top of your mat. Rest your arms. Left hand to left hip. Shift your weight into your left leg. Engage your left leg so left kneecap comes up towards left hip. It's going to engage the quadriceps. Shifting the weight into your left foot. Bend your right knee. Right hand comes to right ankle. Hug knees together. Lift your heart. Lift your left arm. Knee, right knee stays towards the ground as you kick your right foot back towards your right hand. Reach forward with your left arm, dancer pose. Dance. Dancing between desire and judgment. Dancing with your breath. Breath to dance with your body. Strong left leg. Right knee comes to meet the left knee. Arms release down by the sides. Tadasana. And flow. Inhale, arms up, look up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your palms, step back, downward facing dog. Inhale, ripple forward, plank pose. Extend heels back, reach chest forward. Option to lower the knees on the ground or keep them lifted. Exhale, elbows send back towards the hips, lower towards your belly. All the way to the ground, knees, chest, chin. Bring the forearms around in front of you. Lift your chest. Walk the elbows back here so that your shoulders are right over your elbows. Hug your elbows towards one another. Lift your right leg, place your right foot onto the floor. Lift your left leg, place your left foot on the floor. Extend through the top of your head. Same thing that we did before. Can you bring those shoulder blades towards one another on your back so that your heart is completely open? Draw your elbows towards your hips. Draw your shoulders back towards your heels. Sphinx pose. To the earth, look to the right, rest your arms down by your sides, palms face up. Bring your right ear to the ground, look to your left. Shoulders, look to the ground, press up. Table pose or straight back, downward facing dog. Right foot comes forward, left heel comes to the earth, warrior one. Root down through your legs, rise up. Foundation in your feet, right heel in line with left arch, hands to your hips. Bring right hip back, left hip forward. Tuck the pelvis, draw the belly in, bend your right knee deep. Arms come forward, move the shoulders onto your back and extend the arms up. Press the energy down through your back left heel, palms come together. Inhale, lift your chest, look up towards the ceiling. Left hip keeps moving forward, right hip draws back. Open your arms out like wings, straighten your right leg. Bring your right hand onto your right hip. Left arm reaches up. Plug the left shoulder down on your back. Lower your left hand down onto the inside of your right foot on a block. Now you choose. Left hand on the block or on the earth. Left hand to the inside of the right foot or to the outside of the right foot. Parivritta Trikonasana, revolve triangle. Stay here or reach your right fingertips out to the jungle. Draw right shoulder blade on your back and extend right arm up towards the sky. Feet stay grounded. Left rib cage rotates over towards the right leg as you extend right arm straight up and out. Breathe. Can you lift your left hip up as you draw your right hip back? Bend your right knee, place your hands to frame your right foot and step back, downward dog. Left foot forward, right heel in, warrior one, root down to rise. Finding your way into the second side. Tuck through the tailbone. Draw through the core as you send the energy through your back right heel. Squaring hips forward. Shoulders soft. Palms can come together if you wish to sink into a deeper expression of a back bend in your warrior one. Left hip back. Right hip forward as you stay curling through core. Open the arms like wings. straight in your left leg. Left hand to left hip. Lower the right hand down to the earth. On the inside or outside of your left foot, on a block of the earth. Left arm reaches towards the bamboo wall out to the street. Plug the left shoulder onto your back. Inhale, reach your left arm high. Press through your heel, send right heel down. Lift your right hip, draw your left hip back. Beautiful. Awesome, hip adjustment. Breathe. Even as the heart is beating, energy flowing inside, can you hold stillness? Use the breath to breathe here. Heal. Bend your left knee, set props out of your way, plant your palms, step back. Downward facing dog. Curl, ripple forward, plank pose. Option for knees to be on the ground or lifted. Shift forward, exhale, chaturanga dandasana. Elbows by your ribcage, lower to the belly. Forehead to the earth. Bend your knees. Grab the tops of your feet. Inhale, lift your chest, look forward. Exhale, kick your feet into your hands. Lift and open. Good. Continue to lift. You may be rocking here on your belly a little bit. As you lift your chest, expand your heart. Lift your knees towards one another and off the earth. So there's this little bit of rocking sensation on your belly. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, kick back. Move knees towards one another. Good, good. Exhale, lower right ear to the floor. Arms down by your side. Take breath. Gaze down towards the earth. Bend your knees. Grab onto your ankles. Flex your toes down towards the ground. As you exhale, kick your feet into your hands. Lift your chest and keep your thighs on the ground. As you lift your chest, open your heart. Move, navigate those shoulders towards one another. Lift, lift, lift. Give it a little bit more. Inhale, lift, kick back. Flex the toes towards the earth. Yes. Exhale, lower opposite ear to the floor. Just a moment here to allow and feel. Downward facing dog. Downward facing dog, walk your feet towards your hands. Heels turn in, toes point out. Sink your butt down towards your heels. You got two blocks close by. You can sit on one or both blocks. Bring your hands to your heart. Palms together, yogi squat. Hug your knees to the outside of your arms. Your arms to the outside of your knees as you lift the leg into the crown of your head. Interlace your fingers together. And just begin to rotate your wrists in one direction. Now go the other way. Good. And then relax.
It
is awkward. So from here, I'm going to demonstrate and then you can move into it. We're going to use our bolster and blanket as a crash pad in front of us. Option for starting off, the hands are as wide as your shoulders, and then your knees come to the outside of your arms. This is option A, and the knees come to the outside of the arm. You hug your knees to the outside of the arms, and you just look towards forward out in front of you past your crash pad. So you bring one heel in, keep shifting forward, moving energy forward, other toe comes forward. To go farther from that, you bring the knees literally to the back side of your tricep muscles, up into your armpits. Same thing. Your gaze moves forward past the crash pad. Feel the breath. You want to look past the crash pad because if you look down, you're going to go down. So bring your gaze towards the mirror. Yeah, perfect. Strong breath. One heel comes in. Shift more forward. Yes. So if you get the variation with the knees to the outside of the arms, bring the knees to the triceps up in your armpits. Gaze is soft. Breath is fluid. Over into the right side when you bring your left knee in. Strong core. Yeah. Good. And then when you've had your play, we'll meet in a seated position. Send your legs out in front of you. Bring your fingertips back behind you. Lift your chest. Send the energy down through your sitting bones and your heart up. Plant your hands to the outside of your hips, Dandasana, stack pose. Reach and lengthen through the crown of your head. Flex your toes back. Extend your heels forward. Same thing here. We want to keep this open heart, shoulders moving towards you on the back as you start to reach your chest towards your knees. Begin to tuck your chin, keep shoulders back, heart forward, Paschimottanasana, seated forward fold. Elbows stay close to your body. Open your heart, really expand through your chest so you're reaching your belly button towards your knees. Tuck your chin slightly, so natural curve through the spine. Inhale, come up. Bend your left knee. Your left knee points to the back left corner of your mat. Sole of your left foot to the inside of your right thigh. Good. Rotate the hips back to point forward now. Right hip back, left hip forward. Right fingertips to the outside of your right leg. Left hand comes to the outside of your left leg. Lift your chest. Turn the left ribcage towards the right knee and start to reach your heart forward towards your right pinky toe. Tuck your chin just a little bit. Janu Shirshasana. Single leg forward fold. good variations. I like the chest, it's reaching forward, long spine. Right toes flexing back, strong right leg. Your left knee with your hands, cross your left foot up and over your right knee. Shift into your right leg, bend your right knee and bring your right heel towards your left hip. Slide over towards your right, bringing left hip back towards the floor, left sitting bone is rounded. Sprinkle your left fingertips anchored back behind you, right arm up, inhale, long right side body. Exhale, bend your right elbow, hook it to the top of your left thigh. Lift your chest, left shoulder draws back, right shoulder reaches forward, gaze follows your left shoulder. Lift your heart up, press your left hip into the floor. Listen, you straighten your bottom right leg, your bottom right leg. Now cross your left foot up and over your right leg. Just from there, flex your right toes back towards you. And just hug your left knee into your chest. Yeah. Lift your heart up. Press down through both sitting bones. Extend through your heart. Left shoulder back, right shoulder forward. Bend your right knee points towards the back corner of your mat, right foot to the inner left thigh. Come up onto fingertips, lift your chest. Reach your right arm over towards the outside of your left leg. Flex your left toes back, lift your heart. Bend your elbows, reach your chest over towards your left. Send your right hip back. Long spine. From here, tuck your chin slightly, gaze to the earth. Single leg forward fold. Twist open towards the jungle, hooking the left elbow on top of the right thigh. Lift your chest, twist and turn. Let your gaze follow your right shoulder. As you send your right hip down into the earth, lift your chest. Awesome. Look forward, release the twist. Plant your feet on the floor in front of you. Come to the center of your mat. Send your arms forward, palms face up. Draw your core in, slowly. Lower onto your back. Keep core strong. As you lower vertebra by vertebra. Slow, control. When you arrive, take a mini shavasana. Let your legs go long and your arms rest by your sides. Let your face soften. And feel. Digest this pose. Either knees come in together to touch, feet go wide, or bring the soles of your feet together. Let your your knees go on. Take your hands and slide them up underneath of your low back. You want to make sure that you have space in your lumbar spine. So we think the best thing to do is flatten out the back, but actually you want to keep a natural curve in your low back. Your chest. Interlace your fingers around your front right knee. Now press your right knee into your hands. Press into your low back so you create a nice lumbar curve. Counter it. Press the knee into the hands as you press your butt into the earth. Feel more of a curve in your low back. Straighten your right leg to the sky. Bring your hands to the back side of your right hamstring. Interlace the fingers. So on the hamstring or the calf above or below the knee joint. Straighten your right leg. Press through your butt. Extend your right heel to the sky. Flex your left right toes towards you. Strong left leg. Flex your left toes back towards you. Nice. Your right knee. With your left hand, twist. Cross the right knee over to the left. Extend your right arm out to the side of the floor. Right knee moves to the left. Keep reaching your right hip to the right. So initiating that low lumbar curve as you reach the right hip back towards the earth, over towards the right arm. As you reach right knee to the right, to the left. Towards you, extend your left heel up. Shoulders rest on the earth. So if shoulders are on the earth, that may mean that your hands may be on your hamstring opposed to your calf. Straight and strongly through your left leg as you flex your left toes in towards your body. Thank you. bend your left knee. Right hand navigates the left knee to twist. Left knee moves to the right. Left arm anchors into the ground. Left knee moves right, left hip moves left. That your body would benefit going into now before you take rest. When you choose to drop into Shavasana, surrender to any movement from this place. Allow your entire body to melt into the earth. To receive as you let go of any doing and you allow yourself to just be here with your breath. Thank you. around you. Your feelings on your body, your skin. Noises. As you tune in to the feelings, the energy going on within you. Reminding yourself, as humans, we'll always have desires. The best we can do is get clear on what it is we're desiring, so that our judgments result in the best possible choices we can make. Practicing awareness on and off the mat, so that our action and our choice of no action is for the best at this moment. Inhale, take a full body stretch, bend your knees and roll to one side of your body. Rest here, shoulder and ear, knees into chest. A couple more minutes here, unless you're ready to sit up in your meditation position. Bolsters under the sitting bones, shoulders above the wrists, heart open, palms on your thighs, elbows relaxed. Find the best seat. Sit bones down, heart up, shoulders back, spine long. As you sit, listen, feel to what's happening outside of you, and then turn the gaze inside, observing what's happening inside of you as you breathe. Connect to the prana as you sit and dance with your breath. Palms come together, let there be space between each finger, space in your mind, with your head. You can chant Om with me one time or just listen. Full breath, inhale, exhale. Inhale. Namaste. hospital as you're all cleaning up your mats, hanging them up, I'll give you some Dhanasa announcements.